Alright guys, welcome back to Stobet channel, and here today I'm going to continue my gameplay about Hellknight General Sacrifice.
And that the world of man was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh...
Wait, I need to go. I think he is. Alright.
They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel. And made them into stars.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind?
I feel...
loved ones?
Something wrong.
To head deep into the wild.
I'm surprised about this statue.
Perhaps never to return.
Oh shit. Let's make me... afraid.
Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything.
Alright.
Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones. Into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
Wait. Oh no. How can I go? Where? Where I need to go?
Listen, focus, listen. It's magic, it's magic. It's an illusion. She's been in the forest like this before. This reminds me of some of the forest.
Where? Oh, that's a bridge.
Forest in the wilds. The wilds.
The gates work now.
She went to the wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wilds?
Thank
she
you.
Wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat her darkness?
No.
I will open this door first.
Truth helped her.
Oh no. From mother's side.
She's dead. She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian.
She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian.
But she didn't work. She thought her curse would affect him. She thought her curse would spread to him. She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too. She nearly died. She thought the curse made her tainted. Druth helped her.
Maybe like this. I don't understand. Oh, all right, I see. There's a way in there. So I need to go back here. to go right now. Wow, now I can open this door. All right. So where I need to go? Oh, it's the enemy in there. It's so scary. How can I go? Wait. I'm still thinking about it. Why not? It must be work. Okay. And I will go through the door and going to up there, and we did it. Yeah, it's warm. Thank you. Oh, wait. Okay, like this. I can make way for this bridge. Okay. I'm ready. Wait, something wrong maybe? Maybe something wrong? I don't know. Look. Oh, right. This way.
The gate is open.
Open.
There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill her.
Not a very open.
Yet. I'll gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillian before her time comes?
Look. Wow, it's gone. Okay, I see the way how to get there.
Speak to me, Drew. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findon. The Northmen captured Findon's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon? Burnt away.
I think in this.
But from the flames.
This place, we're going to. Against the monster again. I just feel like that.
Truth. The man that I am now.
Maybe I need to go back to this ring.
And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
Oh no, I need to be careful. Careful, be careful, be careful. Careful. Don't get down. Don't get down. Hey, dude. Oh, behind you.
I remember. It didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in, it strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom, drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back. But there, in the darkness,
Senua.
And she remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua, take my iron mirror. Look into it, for it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to...
Who is there?
You will also see that as behind much as the her. Darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped.
Oh, it's a scare.
Focus.
No.
Focus.
It's scare.
Focus.
I see you. I see you now.
Okay. You come on. Fight with me. What the hell? Okay. So play with me. Okay, got you. No, come on, wake up. Kid, come on, wake up. Come here. Oh, he's gone again. Oh shit. That's cool. Okay, got you, and you dead murder Parker, you're dead. All right, motherfucker, you're dead.
It was an illusion, but not this time.
Oh, got you. Kill him. I'm very angry, you know.
The mark of Valravn. One of the keys to the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for Druth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.
I'm coming. I still hear you.
Wow, look. The atmosphere arts become beautiful. Oops, the sky is art blue. Alright guys, that's my gameplay. I will continue to the next game. See you guys. Thank you for watching.